In this tutorial, we will enter the manual calibration for a flow meter and learn how to calibrate it using the nozzle catch tests in the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid control module. Calibrating the flow meter based on the factory tag is a good start, but performing a nozzle catch test calibration will ensure that products are applied with the correct rates. The actual flow meter calibration accounts for worn nozzles or leaks in the system that affect the flow rate. First, make sure the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid sprayer profile is active in Universal Terminal. Access the calibration menus by tapping the gear icon. The red X indicates that the flow sensor is not calibrated, so we'll tap the flow sensor to see the calibration options. There are four methods of calibrating the flow sensor: manual, nozzle catch test, static dispense volume, and field dispense volume. And we will cover the first two methods in this tutorial. Manual calibration requires the flow meter calibration value printed on the side of the flow meter. With manual calibration selected, tap the next arrow. Here we will enter the value found on the flow meter tag. It is important to recognize that the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid module requires a value entered in pulses per gallon, but some manufacturers supply their calibration number in different units. For example, Raven flow meters have their calibration value listed in pulses per 10 gallons, so we would divide that tag number by 10 before entering it in the display. The Raven flow meter on our example sprayer has 720 pulses per 10 gallons written on the tag. So after dividing by 10, we will enter a calibration number of 72 pulses per gallon. Tap the next arrow. Verify that the displayed value is correct and is properly converted to pulses per 1 gallon. Tap the green check. Notice that the red X on the flow sensor has changed to a green check, indicating that it is now calibrated. Now we will perform the nozzle catch test calibration to verify that the actual flow rate matches the display readings. In this method, we will catch the liquid from a single nozzle in a container and measure the total volume dispensed. To begin, tap the flow sensor button and then select Nozzle Catch Test from the dropdown. Tap the next arrow. To dispense liquid while the sprayer is not moving, a simulated ground speed and a target rate will need to be entered. We recommend using a ground speed and target rate that the applicator will actually be applying product in the field. For our example, we will enter 8 miles per hour and 12 gallons per acre. Make sure a container is positioned to collect product from a single nozzle and tap the start button. Product will begin dispensing and the display shows the running time and accumulated pulses. You could tap stop at any time, but to simplify the math, we suggest collecting product for 1 minute. When the running time reaches 60 seconds, tap the stop button. We need to measure the volume of product dispensed into the container. In this scenario, the machine dispensed 0.30 gallons. Since we collected product for 1 minute, we will enter the observed flow rate of 0.30 gallons per minute. Product should be dispensed for a minimum of 1 minute, but can be dispensed for a longer period. When using a longer time, the total volume must be divided by the total time to get a value in gallons per minute. Tap the next arrow. The new adjusted calibration value is displayed. To save and complete the calibration, tap the green check. You can repeat the calibration by tapping the flow sensor button if you'd like to use a different nozzle to verify multiple nozzles across the boom. Now you will be able to calibrate a flow meter using the manual and nozzle catch test methods. For more information on the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid rate module, please refer to the DirectCommand ISOBUS Liquid Feature User Guide. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from Ag Leader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.